It's like 2:45, and this is the outdoor wedding. So, like, that's the main road out there, and there's, I don't know, a better part of 75 cars here. Pretty muddy. I guess that's where they're going to do the photos of them, right? Truth is, I'm out here killing time. There's a lot more religious theme here than I'm normally accustomed to. Most of my life is, oh God, almost entirety of my life is spent secularly. And so there's a lot of nostalgia and a lot more like displays of religiosity than I normally see. So it doesn't bother me or anything. I mean, I was brought up in the real church anyways, the first American church, so yeah, everything's secondary. Well, it doesn't even matter. So I'm gonna walk up here, and you can see this is like where they do the photos. Hear this song? There's something out here, I have no idea what that thing is, that orangey thing there. Oh, he knows, a croquet set. So there's no booze here. No wine, no beer, no booze. There's no vegetarian stuff, really. You know, unless you... Or just that kid just do a haste, face plant there. Oof. If I did that, I'd be going to the ER. It's better over here in the shade. Can't wear a hat because Greg Proop says guys shouldn't wear ball caps. And I've been gone now for about 10 minutes. I don't know how much longer I can get. Oh yeah, there's the bathrooms. God, it's really... you know, I don't even like using those at the park. I won't use those at the park. There's a house over here, but no one's allowed to go in it. It's sort of like that Curb Your Enthusiasm. Yeah, chuck gum over here. The tree so the kids don't walk through it. Oh, watch. We'll go up here and see these kids. Take the scenic route. Actually, I'm trying to take the shady route here. As I said, Greg Proop says a guy can't wear a ball cap in public. I just put on my sports coat, too, because it's too hot out here. I'm already pretty casual now. More casual than I've ever been at a wedding.
He said, I'd like to touch upon my life and my love for her. And I said, well, maybe we should get together and talk, and we did. And during that conversation, I felt like it was an appointment. It was an honor. And to hear Nate's story, and to hear that there was a period of time in his life when he could not articulate all that he had been through. And also that there was a journey in his life that God had brought to him. A journey of restoration that has culminated this day
about
into him finding the words that perhaps he never thought he would find when he found this day. The name of the song is called Forever I'll Do.